You may be seated. We're gathered together in this place at this appointed time in the presence of our Creator and in the view of these witnesses to realize the covenant love relationship of Lyza Wills and Ronnie Hansen. Though marriage is much maligned in our culture, this honorable state is God's chosen process by which two separate beings become one. In Genesis, it says, the Lord God said, it's not good for the man to be alone. And then it says, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. There is risk here, and mystery, and life-changing power. And because of it, marriage should not be entered into lightly or carelessly. It is a holy commitment of one life to another. It's a promise made for keeps, with the living God as witness. So today, Lyza and Ronnie, I'm going to ask you to show your desire to make this commitment by three signs. But first, before we get to those signs, it is important to remember that no couple makes it through to this point in life without the help of a lot of people, a lot of family, and a lot of friends. Fun times together, play, shopping trips, dinner, school, family times, Christmas is spent together. You all have contributed to the lives of these two people. And so you share a rightful portion of their joy today. And on behalf of them, I want to say to you, thank you. Now, but today marks a change. After today, everything's going to be different. Family relationships are different from now on. And so I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
This is the first sign of your commitment. Ronnie, I'm going to ask you a question, and you'll know the answer. Ronnie, will you have this woman, this unique creation of God, to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, and turning your back on all others, keep only to her as long as you live? And Lyza, will you have this man, this unique creation of God, to be your husband? Will you love him and comfort him and honor and keep him and turning your back on all others, keep only to him as long as you both live?
I will.
Please join hands. And let's come up here. And you guys can face each other and hold hands. And look longingly into each other's eyes. Well, I talk for just a little bit. It is very seldom that I get to marry two people that have known each other for so long, that know each other so well as these two do. Very few couples have been friends as long as these two have, let alone dated off and on from the time they were, what, 12 to the present? Not many people have the good fortune to be able to marry their sixth grade sweethearts. So thanks to that fact, you guys have already gotten over a lot of the hurdles that are a problem for a lot of couples. I'm not worried about any of that stuff for you guys. You know how to communicate. You get each other. You know who's likely to leave a bowl in the sink overnight. And you know who's likely not to be pleased with that. Ronnie. But even though this whole event is camouflaged in the ordinary life you've been living, the fact is today everything is different. This ceremony isn't just some cultural hoop that you're going to jump through. The promises you're making today are a line drawn in the sand by the hand of God. I mean, this is crazy. In a minute, I'm going to lead you through a promise in which you're going to basically say that no matter how bad your life gets, so like if Ronnie gets some kind of wasting disease and is bedridden for the rest of his life, or no matter how good life gets, so Liza's banking career takes off and she becomes a wealthy investment banker and she begins to think about her options. In a little while, I'm going to lead you in a promise that says, whatever happens, good or bad, I will never desert you to save myself, and I will never dump you for a better option. That's the promise that we're making here today. You're vowing lifelong fidelity and promising never to break that vow before God. Who remembers? That's a big promise. And the change begins with flowers, beautiful flowers, and it continues with champagne and celebration later on. But it survives, it keeps going through determination and strenuous effort. Unity comes by the willing surrender of your own desires to that of the one you love. And by determining to put your spouse ahead of yourself, Lyza must be more important to you than yourself, Ronnie. And Ronnie has to be more important to you than even yourself. This is a concept we don't talk about much. It's called mutual submission. In a letter to some Christians, one of Jesus' apostles wrote, "Submit yourselves one to another in love. Give yourselves up for each other in love." Jesus, the Son of God, who among other things came to show us how to live a genuine human life, said, "Whoever saves his life will lose it." In other words, the more you hold on to your own life, the more it slips right through your fingers. He also said, "Whoever loses her life will find it." And that's the reality. When you two give yourselves up to each other in absolute love, putting your own will aside, that's when love becomes rich and deep and beautiful and wonderful. And you're already well along the way there. Lyza, you know Ronnie's needs better than anybody. You know his strengths, his weaknesses. You know all the things he needs all along the way. Your job is going to be to love him the way he needs to be loved. Not the way you maybe feel like loving. And Ronnie, the same thing for you. You know Liza's hopes, you know her dreams, you know what she wants to become, you know who she is. You need to love her the way she needs to be loved. Not the way you may be feeling like loving. And the crazy truth is that when you choose to give yourself up for each other, everybody's needs are met. You're not taking care of yourself, somebody else is taking care of you. And that's the reality, that's the goal. Here's a picture. My wife is a weaver and she's a spinner. And so she takes raw wool and she puts it in the spinning wheel. She turns it into a thread. And then she takes another, usually a different color, and she puts it in. She weaves, spins another strand. And then she takes those two strands and she puts them in together. And under the twining of the wheel, they bend and they twist and they move around. One takes up space, the other left behind. But they become even stronger and they become more beautiful than they were before. And they can last and last. But a third thread would make it even stronger. In a teaching about friendship, the Old Testament book Ecclesiastes says, "A cord of three strands is not easily broken." You're one strand, Lyza. You're another strand, Ronnie. And a third strand is the living God. Strand of eternity around which your mortal fibers are twisted. And I know where you guys are on this. If you will allow it, he will give you the strength to keep the promises you're making today more profoundly and more amazingly than you ever thought possible. My prayer is that your lives will be so entwined. Shall we continue? All right. As your intent to pursue becoming one flesh has been made clear by your joining hands, I ask you for the second sign, and that is the proclamation of your devotion. So Ronnie will begin with you, and you simply repeat after me. I, Ronnie, take you, Lyza.
I, Ronnie, take you, Lyza.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
Better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
in sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Your turn, Lyza. I, Lyza, take you, Ronnie.
I, Lyza, take you, Ronnie.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
We're in the home stretch. Having joined hands and proclaimed your devotion, I ask you now for the third sign of commitment. And what do you bring as a token of this promise?
Rings.
May I please have the rings? Thank you. No fear, the rings are here. Yeah. And if you join me, I'm going to pray for this couple. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, encircle these two with a wall of your love. Keep empathy and understanding within that wall. Keep fear and distrust out. Keep wisdom and understanding within. Exclude suspicion and self-doubt. Holy Trinity, as these rings are worn, encircle these two with your joy. Keep mutual submission within and self-centered living without. Three in one, encircle Lyza and Ronnie with your peace. Keep contentment and freedom within. Keep laughter and love within. And keep out worry and fear. By your power, may they stand encircled in selfless love as long as they live and forever. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So Ronnie, yeah, go ahead. You can, Ronnie, you can take Liza's ring. And say, with this ring, I commit myself to you.
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 And now, Ronnie and Lyza, having completed the three signs of their commitment, now they will light the unity candle as a final symbol of the promise made. Give them a little photo op.
Smile.
There you go. As Jesus blessed the wedding at Cana, may he bless this marriage, turning the water of ordinary living into the sweet wine of gladness. Inasmuch as Ronnie and Lyza have agreed together in the holy covenant of marriage and have established the covenant before God and this company by joining hands, proclaiming their devotion, and the giving and receiving of the rings, to the joy of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, I pronounce them husband and wife. Here's the good part. You may kiss the bride. Give a smile. It is now my great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Hansen. Sidewalk outside, so you can go out the back or down the stairs and kind of join the line. Greet them and give them your blessing. Amen.
You're fine, don't even worry about it.